The skywalk in Peling is a glass-bottomed walkway built along the 137-foot-tall Chan Rasik statue that was opened to public in the year 2018. The ticket counter is at the bottom of the skywalk, following which you have to take a spiral staircase that will lead you to a platform with the skywalk on one side and the tall statue on the other. We took the skywalk first. Here, you will have to open your shoes before getting onto the glass. As we were visiting in the later half of the day, the number of tourists around this place was comparatively less. The views of the mountains above and the valleys below was fascinating. On a clear day, the peak of Kanchenjunga is also visible from here. However, once you look down at the glass floor below your feet, the view here is not so neat. Here you can see only the road and the cars parked on it. A beautiful garden below would have enhanced the experience manifold. Nevertheless, the visitors here seemed pretty happy with their experience and were busy getting their best shots with the giant statue and the beautiful mountain ranges in their backdrop. Another thing that you have to keep in mind while visiting the skywalk is that the place can turn out to be quite stinky, with many people walking with their shoes off, thus exposing their not so pleasant smelling socks. Once you are done with the walk on the glass, it is time to head towards the giant statue. Being built on a ridge, you have to climb several steps to reach it. With the inauguration of the Chan Rasik statue, it apparently forms some sort of triangle with the statue of Guru Padmasambhava in Namchi and the statue of Lord Buddha in Ravangla, both of which being situated in South Sikkim. On the top of the stairs, there is a small garden with a statue in the middle. A walk on the pathways built along the edges of the ridge gives a beautiful view of the mountain ranges. There is also a monastery built below the statue. Although a small one, with its unique design and the spiraling pathway around leading to the top of the statue, gives it a charm of its own. Though photography isn't permitted within the monastery, you can get some amazing photographs and views from the top deck above the statue. With the setting sun rendering a golden hue to the sky, we got a beautiful view from here. On a clear day, not only can you view the snow-covered mountain peaks, but you will also be able to view many faraway settlements in the valleys below. Not far away from the giant statue and the skywalk is one of the oldest monasteries of Sikkim, the Sangha Choling Monastery. Built according to the ancient Tibetan architecture, it houses several ancient paintings, accessories, and clay statues. By the time we visited, the monastery was already closed for the day, but we could anyway enjoy the tranquility of the place. The colorful buildings of the past amidst the picturesque backdrop of the great Himalayas is always a treat to the eyes. The monastery is beautifully decorated with bright colors, prayer flags, and a stupa, making it the best place to end the day in peace.